for the adults. So if you have a program, send it to the aisle. If you have a program, send it to the aisle, please. And then just sit with my heart. Thank you. Hey, give me the program.
Welcome to our GMS News Veterans Day live stream for the year of 2018. The event will start soon.
We have a
If you are joining us now, you're joining us at our Greenwood Middle School Veterans Day Convocation live stream. Our event will start soon.
Make your way into the water flag, please. This means that we're going to fill in the 7th graders right there. Just a second. We're going to do it.
Thank you for joining us at Greenwood Middle School for a Better Days Convo. It will start soon.
Welcome again to our GMS News Veterans Day Convocation live stream. If you're joining us now, the event will start soon. Welcome to our GMS News Veterans Day live stream for this Veterans Day Convocation of 2018. If you're joining us now, the event will start soon. If you're joining us now, this is our GMS Veterans Day Convocation live stream, and our event will start soon at around 8:15.
Thank you. Thank you.
Kluger, Mr. Fletcher, Mr. Morris, as they work each and every day with these kids. The band sounded terrific as they do, as well as Miss Lincourt and Mr. Morris, who's not here, but all the efforts they put in to getting the choir ready for a day like this today. So, as I mentioned in the beginning, we take time out. I want to thank you again for taking time out of your day to come with us to this Veterans Day program. But we like to at least try to make sure that not only today are we honoring our veterans, but we try to make an effort in the last few years to continue that throughout the school year for these kids. Just kind of remind them it's just not a one day, that we are grateful for everything they have done for us in this country. So we put our efforts into it's in the honor flight. And a lot of you may know it, some of you may not have heard of it before, but they are dedicated in getting veterans to Washington, D.C. for a day and seeing the monuments that were memorials that were built for them out in D.C. It's a one-day trip. They go leave early in the morning, and then they will return later on in the evening. Their efforts are moving towards, obviously, the World War II veterans, then the Korean War, the Vietnam, and those things kind of continue to move down the line. So we have a video here, and it's something special they really do, and we've had a lot of letters sent. They, on the way home from Washington, D.C., you'll see they have something they call mail call, where family members, just community members, kids, adults of all kinds, will write thank you letters to the veterans. And on their way home, on the plane, they get a package during mail call and get to read those letters from, like I said, family members, and just people who are very appreciative of our veterans, okay? And then they come back to the airport, they fly out of Indianapolis, they just had one come back, and the next one going out, in April, the next one's going out in April, so we're hoping our efforts right now will help get some of those veterans out in April. They take off from the Indianapolis International Airport, then they will return. So with that, if you could please just give me a few minutes here. We're going to show you the video real quick. Mr. Taylor, if you'd like to hit the lights for me, please. Yeah, go ahead and turn them off. It was working this morning, I promise you, we checked it. I absolutely promise you. The volume worked, it was straight. I know. It's well worth the wait, I promise you.
Family of It's not distinct at first. Something is out there, but you can't cure it from the core.
So this has been a tradition, thanks God. Don't come back on. I promise you, don't come back on. This has traditionally been the time of the year that we kick off our efforts in the fundraising for in the honor flight. We have things planned throughout the year to get the kids involved, and our goal is to send veterans to Washington, D.C. in April, and then get some groups out there to welcome them home on that day. We'll give more information as time gets closer for that stuff, but there's a red bucket that's right over here, a red bucket right here. If you'd like to make a small donation, whatever you like to, like I said, this is what kind of kicks off our efforts to start the fundraising each and every year for In the Honor Flight. So, with that, and I'm so blessed, I feel With that, Mrs. Baker.
At this point, we would like to take a moment to honor some of those soldiers who have paid the ultimate sacrifice and never been returned home. So I ask for a moment of silence while we honor those veterans, please. Army Master Sergeant Peter A. McKenna, Jr. Sergeant James Slate. Command Sergeant Major Timothy Bullard. Sergeant First Class Raymond R. Transfiguration. Army Sergeant First Class Christopher Solis. Army Chief Warrant Officer Taylor Galvin III. Air Force Staff Sergeant James T. Grogan. Master Sergeant Jonathan J. Dunbar. Staff Sergeant Deshaun Briggs. Army Staff Sergeant Conrad Robinson. First Lieutenant Weston C. Lee. And Air Force Staff Sergeant Alexandria M. Barrow.
Thank you.
Greenwood Middle School, we participate in a VFW essay contest. It is put on by the VFW, and they have a different theme of the year. And students here work on essays that are around that theme. And this year's theme for the Patriots Pen was Why I Honor the American Flag. We had a lot of wonderful submissions for that. I will get to those awards in just a moment. The top three they get a gift card from us, a certificate. And then our top ones that we have picked go on to our local VFW, and they do their own, obviously, contest. And those sometimes match up with how our top three, and sometimes they don't. But there are opportunities there for scholarships, some money that you can win, some awards, and actually we had a student last year make it to nationals in that competition. So I'm going to name off some students that just had essays that were so good that we could not recognize them. So students, if I call your name for an honorable mention, I just ask that you stand where you're at, and then we will applause at the end of all those names. So the honorable mention essays were James Baugh, Samuel Castle, just go and stand up, Annie Abrahamian, is that right? Probably not, sorry. Eva Dean, Andrew Soboleski, Emma Baker, Stuart Lutigo, and Jessica Lott. Let's have a round of applause. The third place winner will get a certificate here as well as a gift card to the movies. Who doesn't like that? Is Joshua Serkin. So if you come on up, Joshua.
Our rights and freedoms, We would be in a place far from the America that I love. There's a line in the national anthem that I find very powerful, and it is a wonderful symbol for America's spirit. The line, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. See, the country I love refuses to go down without a fight. The country I love fights for its freedom. The country I love never fell to the ground during that battle because those stars and stripes represent my America and the nation I live in. When I honor that flag, I see my nation, my freedom, and lives dedicated to the USA.
Thank you.
so appreciative, and we want to thank you once again. There's not enough times, enough days to do this for you folks, but we always like to take a little bit of each year to do this. So thank you once again, and I hope that you have a safe and a great rest of your year. And one more time, can just give them a round of applause.
Thank you for joining us today with our GMS News Veterans Day Convocation, the 47th annual Veterans Day Convocation here at GMS. Thank you for joining us. Just one quick last message. Thank you for all our veterans who are serving now, and even if you decide to serve, thank you for your honor to this country.
Thank you.